This is an interval. Okay, it's also an array in PHP and other programming languages, but right now I'm talking about the mathematical notation of intervals. This one shows the interval between 20 and 25, so it includes the numbers 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25. Question, does this interval contain 22? Yes, obviously. Does it contain the number 25? Yes. Right? Here's an interval of two dates, from the 20th of December to the 25th of December. Does December 22 fall within this interval? Yes, obviously. Does December 25 fall within this interval? And we're getting somewhere, I promise. It does, right? This interval contains December 25. Now, does December 25 at 10 o'clock fall within this interval? Does it? It's difficult to tell whether a given timestamp is part of an interval or not. It's actually a problem with all kinds of intervals, not just with dates and times, but with dates and times, it gets a little more complex. Let's say I ask whether 25.5 is contained within the interval of 20 to 25. You'd probably say no. That's because the precision of numbers is implied by the interval's definition. This seems to be an interval containing natural numbers instead of rational numbers, so the interval stops at 25, and 25.5 isn't included. But we tend to think differently about dates and time specifically. You probably think of the 25th of December as the whole day, right? As in every hour, every minute, every second within that day. But if we don't explicitly specify that time within our interval, there's room for confusion. Now, programmers solve this in a clever way. Instead of describing an interval from December 20 to December 25, they say, let's make an interval from December 20 to December 26, but don't include the 26th. So everything before December 26 is included, and it doesn't matter how many hours, minutes, or seconds are counted. Clever, right? This is why PHP doesn't include the end date when you make a date period. It's kind of confusing at first, but it's a very clever way to prevent other problems. Yeah, I don't like being clever. Because, like I said, it creates confusion. And what's interesting is that we have another solution available. Don't compare apples to oranges, or in other words, only compare date ranges that have the same precision. If we're talking about an interval of days, then we shouldn't worry about the time of day. So yes, December 25th should be included within this interval. If we need more precision, then we'll need to manually specify it. No more room for confusion or interpretation. Now, you can create a date period with the end date included in PHP, by the way, but it's not the default setting. For me, the most important lesson here is that clever solutions aren't always the best. I prefer obvious, clear, and intentional code, even if it requires a little more manual work, like making sure you're always dealing with the same precision. What about you? Let me know in the comments down below, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.